Good morning, students. Computer networks. Now, topics in this is a different term, networking devices. So we have already modem, Ethernet card, RJ45 connector. Now, next one is repeater. So repeater, we know that when distance is large, then the signals are very weak. In order to give to the signals, there is a one device that is called a repeater. So usually repeater is required about 100 meter. It means if distance is 100 meter, up to 100 meter, no need to take any type of repeater. So if signal, your distance increase 100 meter, then repeater is required. So repeater is required when distance is 100 meter or above. So in your paper, there are some questions like where repeater is required. So you will have to specify, mention where, if the distance is above 100 meter, then repeater is required. Next is, there is a hub. With a hub and switch, these are control, central controlling device. In this, all the different computers, different nodes are connected with the help of RJ45 connector. So at the backside of your hub, there is a different ports, and the RJ45 connector is connected with that. Now switch and hub, basically same thing is there, but switch are more advanced, because in switch, there is an internal memory that is called your internal memory of your switch. And second one is, switch will decide, it means it is active, it will decide where to send the data according to the IP address. Okay, so both are used in LAN, local area network, but switch is just like a getting the data and forward the data. Okay, it is it will broadcast the data. The limitation of hub is that data of two devices come at the same time, they will collide. It means if it is receiving the data from more than one device, in that is possibility that your data will be disturbed. But switch, I have already discussed, is a smart machine. It is for multiple computers or communication device. When data arrive to a switch, extract destination address from the data packet. So it find out from where data has been sent and to whom this data has been sent, okay? So it will create a table of receiving IP address, and it contain the IP address of sending computer. Everything is saved. Then it forward the multiple packets at the same time from different routes. So a switch does not forward the signal which are noisy and corrupt. So it will stop the packet that is corrupt. Okay, it drops a packet and asks the sender to resend it again. It means it will, we know that our data is divided into packets. If any packet is missing or corrupt, in that case, the switch will get a new copy of same data from sending computer. Next is, so Ethernet switches are, we know that at when you are using broadband, there is a, even just like a Ethernet switches are common. But for a networking LAN, special type of switches are required. So any doubt in this, Vita? If you need any doubt in this?
No, sir.
Next one is router. So we have discussed here hub and switch. Next one is router. So router is a network device that has received, that can receive the data, analyze it, and transmit it to other network. So RubHub and RubSwitch, both of these are required in the same network. So ye hum same network mein use karte hain, hum LAN mein use karte hain. But whenever you are connecting two networks, then we need router. So router kya karta hai ki ye data ko receive karta hai, usko analysis karta hai, then it's transmit it to other network. A router connect a local network to the internet. ठीक है, तो जब भी आपने कोई लोकल नेटवर्क बना हुआ है एंड यू वांट टू कनेक्ट विद दिस विद एन इंटरनेट, द राउटर इज रिक्वायर्ड. एंड रिमेंबर वन थिंग, प्रेजेंट टाइम व्हिच इज दैट राउटर इज इनबिल्ट इन अदर हार्डवेयर डिवाइसेस. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज कंपेयर टू हब एंड स्विच, ए राउटर हैज एडवांस कैपेसिटी एज इट कैन एनालाइज द डेटा बीइंग कैरीड ओवर नेटवर्क, डिसाइड हाउ alter how it is tagged and send it another network of a different type. So switch and hub is a problem. Like switch and hub is used for same network, but router can send the data of a different type network. Different type means their protocol may be different, their topology may be different. Okay, एक हो सकता है start topology, दूसरा हो सकता है bus topology. एक में हो सकता है TCP/IP हम use कर रहे हैं, दूसरे में हो सकता है कि हम UDP यूज कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि UDP इज ए प्रोटोकॉल वेयर डेटा इज सेंड बाय द सेंडर, इट ब्रॉडकास्ट द डेटा, एनीबॉडी कैन रिसीव द डेटा, क्लियर. बट TCP/IP इज अ सिक्योर वन, सो इन केस ऑफ मिसिंग डेटा, डेटा कैन बी रीपैक्ड एंड रीसेंड. तो ए राउटर कैन बी वायर्ड और वायरलेस, ए वायरलेस राउटर कैन प्रोवाइड ए वाईफाई access to the smartphone and other devices. Usually a router are certain contain some parts to provide wired internet access. Okay, so wireless bhi hai aur aapke paas wired dono type ke aapke paas router available. Next term is gateway. To aapke paas jo gateway hota hai, matlab wo aapke paas नेटवर्क को दूसरे एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के नेटवर्क को दूसरे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के नेटवर्क के साथ कनेक्ट करता है. इट मींस वी विल गेट ए बिग नेटवर्क बाय यूजिंग गेटवे. तो आपके पास जो राउटर होता है, दैट इज इन द सेम ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. इट मींस वी आर कनेक्टिंग ए स्मॉल नेटवर्क्स इन सेम ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. बट इफ वी आर वांट टू कनेक्ट टू और मोर networks of different organization, gateway is required. So aapke paas ek gateway between it provide the connectivity between organization network and outside world of internet. Gateway serve as a entry and exit point of network, as all coming in and going of a network must first pass through the gateway in such a order to use routing path. Besides routing packet, gateway also maintain information about the host network internal. ठीक है, तो ये पूरे के पूरे नेटवर्क की कहाँ से डाटा आया है, ठीक है, कहाँ पे ये रिसीव होगा. दिस टाइप ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन इज कंटेन्ड बाय गेटवे. दिस इज एग्जांपल, देयर इज अ वन नेटवर्क ऑफ वन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, अनदर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज देयर, एंड इन बिटवीन वी आर टेकिंग गेटवे. सो इट इज ए एंट्री एंड एग्जिट पॉइंट ऑफ ए नेटवर्क, क्लियर. Next, yes, students, any doubt in this? Chitit? Okay, better. Then, next one is there is a one more term, that is IP address. With every computer that is connected with the internet has a have a special address that is called IP address. So IP address is a unique address. जो भी computer आपके पास internet के साथ connect होगा या network के साथ connect होगा, it will get a special address. That address is called IP address. And IP address has it four parts. Clear? It is a 32-bit numbering address. So इसमें कितने bits का है? 32-bit का. और इसमें four parts है. Means आपके पास 8888 means total हो गया आपके पास 32-bit. और आपके पास ये जो number है, आपके पास ये four parts हैं. Separator is called is here colon. और dot. ठीक है? तो आप dot भी use करते हैं. यहाँ पे इन्होंने colon use किया हुआ है. You will use dot here. Now this IP address contain the information of a connecting device, its geographical location, clear, country, state, city and areas. Okay, everything is saved in the shape of these numbers. Clear? So आपके पास जब भी आप कोई कनेक्टिविटी करते हो दो कंप्यूटर्स में तो टू थिंग्स आर रिक्वायर्ड. वन इज मैक एड्रेस एंड अदर वन इज आईपी एड्रेस. तो मैक एड्रेस इज आईपी एड्रेस आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स, स्टैटिक एंड डायनेमिक. सो व्हेनेवर यू आर यूजिंग इंटरनेट योर आईपी एड्रेसेस आर डायनेमिक. इट मींस इफ यू आर यूजिंग इंटरनेट यू विल रिसीव वन आईपी एड्रेस. लेटर ऑन व्हेन यू आर डिस्कनेक्टेड फ्रॉम द इंटरनेट that IP address will be released and assigned to another person. But whenever you in any network, you are using in any network, in that case, IP addresses are fixed. Okay, that remains same. Take the example of servers. The IP address of servers remains same. So that's why IP addresses are of two type. One is called dynamic, another is called static. And these numbers, like 192, ठीक है, ये नंबर आपके पास जो आपके पास सीरीज है 192, ये आपके पास जीरो से लेके आपके पास 255 तक जा सकती है. ठीक है, तो ये आपके पास ये इसकी रेंज है. यस स्टूडेंट्स, एनी डाउट इन दिस? भूमिका, मानवीय, ओके बेटा.
यस सर.
Any doubt in this video?
No, sir.
Okay, better. Now, next is, there are some protocols and then there are some web services like www, hypertext markup language, okay? So, we are going to discuss that. Okay, students, internet. We know that when we connect two or more computers with each other, there is a network. But internet is a largest network. It is called global network because when we use internet, then the different computers from different cities are connected with each other. So that's why it is a biggest network. So internet stands for international network. So for using internet, we need the connection from internet service provider like Airtel, BSNL, Jio. Clear? So, aapke paas internet connection ke liye ye cheez required. So, aapke paas internet providers different services like in internet we can assess web pages. It is called www. We can use file transfer protocol. We can use email. All of these are different services of internet. And www is a one of that service. So www stands for World Wide Web. So it is a series of web servers that are connected with each other. Pure world mein alag alag places ke upar web servers hain jo aapas mein connected hain. Okay, and these web services contain web pages. Okay, in web servers mein kya save hai? Web pages beta. Okay, so whenever you are accessing, you are opening any website in your computer system, it means you are using www, World Wide Web. The concept of www was introduced by Tim Berners-Lee. Okay, a Tim Berners-Lee, a British computer scientist, invented the www in 1990. Okay, so now in the www we use web pages. Web pages are created in HTML, hypertext markup language. So it is a language for creating a web pages. In this, different commands are enclosed within angular brackets. Okay, so this after pass HTML is the extension .html. Clear? So this is the basic things which you have already. This was in the topic of class 10. HTML, hypertext markup language. Then when you are using the www, you need URL. It is called universal, uniform, or universal resource locator, yeah, identifiers. Clear? So जो भी आपके पास file web server में save होगी उसका एक अपना ही address होता है. एक तो होता है उसका numeric address, that is called IP address. Another is called text address. ठीक है, the text address is called URL. Clear? तो आपके पास किसी भी रिसोर्स जो www में है, कोई वेब पेज है, कोई इमेज है, कोई आपके पास साउंड है, कोई वीडियो है, जो सर्वर में कॉपी है, तो उसके दो एड्रेसेस होंगे. एक तो आईपी एड्रेस होगा और साथ साथ में उसके पास एक उसका टेक्स्ट एड्रेस होगा. और टेक्स्ट एड्रेस क्योंकि आईपी एड्रेस इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू रिमेम्बर, दैट्स व्हाई टेक्स्ट एड्रेस इज रिक्वायर्ड. इट इज कॉल्ड URL, यूनिफॉर्म और यूनिवर्सल रिसोर्स locator, identify URL for locator, but you can also write down identifier. So uniform resource identifier, this is the full form of URL. So here is one example. So in any URL, the main page, the main link, that is called domain name. Okay, for example, you are using here I'm typing one URL here. For example, here is www.swamisandas.com. here swamisandas.com is here domain name. Okay, so after that there is a suppose images are there, there is a images folder are there, then the file name is abc.html. so complete URL for isme jo aapke paas hai https. so here http is a protocol. Okay, www stand for here is a www.swamisandas.com is a domain name. Here www indicate it is a web server. Clear? It is a web server. Now after that there is a images is a folder, abc is a file. So complete is called URL. So kai bar aap kehte ho absolute address, this is absolute address, but jab aap kehte ho relative, then you start from this one, like images and abc.html, like this. This is a relative address. Yes, Sia, any doubt in this?
No, sir.
Okay. So different parts of your URL. These are number one, protocol. Okay, here HTTPS is a protocol. Then types of server. So here we use www means it is a web server. Okay, here Swami Sant Das, here is a domain name. Okay, image is here a folder. You can use folder, subfolder. abc.html is a file. So these are the different types of different parts of URL. Now here is HTTP. It stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. It is a set of rules which is used to retrieve linked web page. बेटा इट इज ए रिक्वेस्टिंग प्रोटोकॉल. तो जब आप किसी भी वेबसाइट के साथ इफ यू आर यूजिंग HTTP, इट मीन्स यू आर रिक्वेस्टिंग टू द सर्वर अबाउट दैट पर्टिकुलर वेब पेज. तो इट इज ए रिक्वेस्टिंग प्रोटोकॉल. तो आपके पास ये आप यूज कर रहे हो रिक्वेस्ट करने के लिए. किसको रिक्वेस्ट करने के लिए? सर्वर को. सर्वर को किसी एक पर्टिकुलर सर्विस के रिगार्डिंग. तो HTTP stand for Hyper Text Transfer Protocol. It is a set of rules which are used to retrieve linked web pages across the web. It is more secure and advanced version is HTTPS. So, aapke paas HTTP is a Hyper Text Transfer Protocol, but HTTPS means Hyper Text Transfer Protocol Secure. These are used by the websites which contain the sensitive data like banking data or social media accounts. Okay, ऐसी वेबसाइट जहाँ पे सोशल मीडिया है या जिसकी सेंसिटिव डाटा है आप HTTPS यूज करते हैं. तो but remember one thing, there is a confusion regarding www and internet. Normally we are thinking that www means internet, but internet has a broad meaning. Okay, so but www has a very limited meaning. It is a narrow meaning. Okay, www is a part of internet. Clear? Then next is domain name system. Okay, so it's, when we fill IP address in searching engine or in your browser, in place of IP address, we fill the URL because URL are very common. It is easy to remember. It is easy to search. But we know that जो आपके पास servers होते हैं, उनके IP address से हम उसका location को find out कर सकते हैं. हम उनके URL से नहीं कर सकते. तो आपके पास domain name system एक ऐसा computer है, एक ऐसा server है जो आपके आईपी आपके यूआरएल को आईपी एड्रेस में कन्वर्ट करता है और आईपी एड्रेस को यूआरएल में कन्वर्ट करता है. इट मींस जब आप किसी भी वेबसाइट के बारे में यूआरएल फिल करते हो, इट गो टू योर सर्वर और सर्वर सेंड दैट यूआरएल टू डीएनएस सर्वर, डोमेन नेम सिस्टम सर्वर. दैट डीएनएस सर्वर ट्रांसलेट द आईपी द यूआरएल इनटू आईपी एड्रेस एंड सेंड दैट आईपी एड्रेस टू द सर्वर एंड देन दैट सर्वर get the data from particular server. ठीक है, वो उस particular server से data receive करता है. तो for example, here is URL is ncert.nic.in. तो इसका एक अपना IP address है. तो domain name system आपके पास contain the information regarding URL and IP addresses. तो ये आपका एक system है. ठीक है, तो जो server इस चीजों को मेंटेन करेगा उसे हम कहते हैं डोमेन नेम सिस्टम सर्वर. तो इसका काम ही क्या है? ट्रांसलेशन इनटू आईपी एड्रेस एंड आईपी एड्रेस इनटू यूआरएल. तो आपके भाई ये देखो, देयर इज ए वन यूजर एचटीटीपी ब्राउजर. ठीक है, तो इन बिटवीन ये इट विल सेंड द आईपी एड्रेस द यूआरएल एंड दैट यूआरएल कन्वर्ट इनटू आईपी एड्रेस. तो ये आप देयर इज ए whenever you are filling the URL, it automatically converted into IP address. But remember one thing, if you daily open the same web page again and again, these type of IP addresses are saved in the shape of cookies. So that's why a DNS server is not required. So this is the benefit of cookies. Now next is, so here we discussed domain name, URL, website. Okay, students, what is website? A multimedia document in www, multimedia document in www is called website. Okay, and collection of these websites are called, the collection is called, yes, it is called web. Web page is a multimedia page, and we connect, when we connect these we get website. What is web server? It's special software that is used to assess web pages. It's called web browser. For example, Mozilla Firefox, there is the Internet Explorer. These are browsers. But browsers may be open source or freeware. So our Internet Explorer hai, that is freeware. But Mozilla Firefox, it is open source. Okay, so what is web hosting? Storing the website in server is called web hosting. तो जब भी आपने एक वेबसाइट बना ली, वो वेबसाइट आपके पास आपके कंप्यूटर में है, तो कोई भी इसको असेस नहीं कर सकता. For assessing it, we need storing that website in web server. या तो आप अपने कंप्यूटर पे वेब सर्वर बना दो, और you can give that file to any other company who has any server. ठीक है, तो वो क्या करेगी, उस पर्टिकुलर वेबसाइट को सर्वर में सेव कर देगी और आपको एक URL प्रोवाइड करेगी. When you get the URL, it means your website is online now. So this is your introduction to web service. So we discussed www, then hypertext markup language, XML. Okay, students, there is one word XML. So XML here stands for, so there are two things here, HTML and XML. Extensible Markup Language. So beta, this type of language is used for creating the scripting language. For example, HTML. HTML में जितने भी tags बने हैं, वो सारे के सारे XML में बने. And more thing, when we are sharing the data from client to server or server to client, we are using XML. ठीक है? तो क्योंकि जब आपके पास आपको किसी भी सर्वर के साथ कनेक्ट होते हो, for example, DBMS server, so it is difficult that we transfer the DBMS table, for example, आप Oracle use करते हो या MySQL, उसके table को भेजना बहुत difficult होता है. तो XML एक ऐसा format, text format है, जो आपकी file को text format में भेजेगा from one DBMS server to another DBMS server, and data will be very lightweighted. Clear? So this is called XML, stand for Extensible Markup Language. So we discussed here domain name, URL, website, web browser, web server, web hosting. We have already discussed networking devices, then topology. Now next is, there are last topic of your syllabus, that is, there is a networking protocols. Clear? So here we have a number of protocols like HTTP, FTP, PPP, SMTP, TCP/IP, POP3, HTTPS, Telnet, VoIP. So we have already discussed HTTP. This is it stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. It is a requesting protocol for assessing the linked link of a particular resource from internet, from server. So HTTPS means Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure. Now we are going to discuss FTP. Okay, students, FTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. ठीक है, Transmission Control Protocol and Internet Protocol. HTML stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol, but TCP/IP stands for Transmission Control Protocol, Internet Protocol. So, जो आपके पास TCP/IP है, इसके two parts है. One is called Transmission Control Protocol, another is called Internet Protocol. तो आपके पास जब भी आप data send करते हो, from client to server or server to client, so your TCP/IP is working in both computers. Clear? In your computer system, also in the server. So main yahan pe ek chote se layout bana raha hu. So here is one computer that is a sender computer. Another computer is a receiver computer. So when we transfer the data, there is a one document. This is your document, your file. The TCP or of receiver, this is a receiver side. Okay. Oh, sorry, sender. And this is receiver. Okay. So when this sender want to send this file to the receiver, first it will take the file, break that file into small packets. Okay, small packets. Each packet contains the IP address of sender and receiver, then serial number and data itself. After that, this is the work of which one? Work of TCP of sender side. So, uske baad ye jo packets hain, ye one by one send hote hain sender to receiver from different routes. ठीक है, सो ये जो जितने पैकेट्स हैं वन बाय वन, ठीक है, अलग अलग रूट से वो ट्रेवल करते हैं और क्लाइंट के कंप्यूटर में पहुंचते हैं. ठीक है, अब इन आईपी इन रिसीवर साइड रिसीव दीज पैकेट्स. ठीक है, और रीअसेंबल द पैकेट्स. बट रिमेंबर वन थिंग, when these packets received in the receiver side, if confirmation message is sent to the sender, he packet received. ठीक है, ऐसे packet, ये packet पहुंच गया. ठीक है, उसके बाद message आएगा, फिर ये packet जाएगा, then message is there. ठीक है, तो जैसे ही आपके पास packet receive होगा, आपके पास message sender computer के पास चला जाएगा. अगर मैसेज सेंडर कंप्यूटर के पास नहीं जाता तो वो पैकेट फिर से रीसेंड हो जाता है. तो रिसीवर साइड में जो आईपी है इन पैकेट्स को रिसीव करता है और टीसीपी उनको रीअसेंबल करता है एंड डिस्प्ले दैट डाटा इन रिसीवर कंप्यूटर. दिस इज कॉल्ड टीसीपी आईपी. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, एनी डाउट इन दिस? इश्नीर, एनी डाउट?
No, sir.
Okay, students, in this chapter, now we will discuss only the protocol FTP, PPP, SMTP, then POP3, Telnet, and UIP. Okay, students, now time is over. Monday, we will complete this chapter.